and welcome to my channel, Dr. Wynn Tran, on YouTube. Today, we will talk about autoimmune disease, what are the symptoms, top 10 common autoimmune diseases, and how do we treat them. I'm a practicing rheumatologist and medical doctor specialized in autoimmune disease and joint pain. So let's go ahead and start it. What is autoimmune disease? Basically, this is a condition in which your immune system mistakenly attacks your own body. Well, normally, the immune system is just like the armed forces in any nations to protect us against invader, foreign subjects. When the immune system detects invaders or foreigners, they will send out a bunch of cells or protein called antibody to attack those invaders. In a healthy, normal person, the immune system is able to distinguish between our body cells and foreign cells. However, in autoimmune disease, the immune system mistakenly they cannot distinguish which one it are, which one is the invader. As a result, the immune system sends a bunch of cell antibody to attack multiple organs in our body. Some autoimmune disease, for example, type 1 diabetes, the antibody attack only one organ, the pancreas, while other disease, such as lupus, the immune system attack multiple organs like kidney, hair, joint, heart, and sometimes the brain. So, why does the immune system attack our body? We're not sure. However, there are some factors that may increase risk of getting autoimmune disease. For example, gender. Women tend to have more autoimmune disease compared to men at a rate of 2-1. Certain groups are, for example, African American or Hispanic, likely to get some disease such as lupus than Caucasian or Asians. Other autoimmune disease like lupus, for example, may run in the family. That means if your parents have the disease, you may have the disease. Well, I say may, not always, because this is just chance. Other factors may increase risk of getting autoimmune disease include environmental factor, such as exposure to certain chemicals or solvents. How about diet? Well, it's possible because some study imply that high fat, highly processed food, and also high sugar diet may lead to chronic inflammation, and this in turn can increase your risk of getting autoimmune disease. What are symptoms of autoimmune disease? Well, most of the symptoms are non-specific. For example, you may feel fatigue, muscle ache, joint pain, you may have some skin rash in your face, you may have some hair loss, you may feel low energy, and occasionally you feel numbness or tingling of your hands. And often, those symptoms, they come and go. And if you pay attention, it usually triggered by some events, for example, stress, or infections, or something that trigger your immune system. There are more than 80 different autoimmune diseases. I'm going to tell you the top 10 most common autoimmune diseases that you may encounter or see it. Well, the first one, very common, heard a lot, it's called rheumatoid arthritis. Well, in this particular autoimmune disease, the immune system antibody attack the joint. And usually they attack small joint, for example, the hand. And you may feel symptoms like joint pain, you feel really stiff in the morning, you feel like your joint swollen. And sometimes the joint really red swollen, or really warm. Now, unlike osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis may attack people at young age, usually 30 and above. And this condition should be treated by a rheumatologist. Well, the next condition is called psoriasis or psoriatic arthritis. Well, I will make individual video for each condition, but in today's talk, I just give you a very brief overview about each autoimmune conditions. Well, psoriasis is a condition that attacks by the immune system to the skin and joints. As a result, the patient have multiple red, thick, sometimes we call silvery flak seen on their skin, in the trunk, the hand, and or joint pain. Treatment of this condition usually by rheumatologists and or dermatologists. Well, the next condition is lupus. Lupus, or we call systemic lupus erythematosus. This is a condition that the immune system attacks multiple organs in the body. Usually they attack the kidney, they attack the hair, cause hair loss. If they attack the joint, they cause joint pain. If they attack the skin, they call lupus or malar rash. And you may see patients, they have rash in the face like a butterfly. Now, treatment for lupus depends on the disease severities and also depend on other factors. And usually this condition is treated by many specialists, include rheumatologists, nephrologists, kidney doctor, and other specialists. Now, next one is called Sjögren syndrome. This disease, the antibody, instead of attack the kidney or other organs like lupus, it attacks saliva gland. It's right here. It basically attacks the gland that produce liquid or produce mucus. Patients with Sjögren syndrome, they have dry eyes, dry mouth, and sometimes dry in vaginals. So those are the common conditions for Sjögren. Sometimes they also have joint pain. The next condition is called vasculitis or blood vessels. In this case, the immune system include antibodies that attack blood vessel, include arteries and veins. Depends on the location of the attack, for example, up in here or inside our body or at the hand, at the legs or feet. These vasculitis have different names. In general, people have vasculitis, they may feel low-grade fever, they may feel fatigue, and in their skin, they may see small red dot. And this is usually due to inflammation of the blood vessel. Now, this condition usually treated by rheumatologists after ordering some labs, and other specialists may treat this condition as well. Now, the next one you probably heard or know is called type 1 diabetes. In this condition, the outer bodies attack the pancreas. Remember, the pancreas is the one that produces insulin-producing cells. As a result of these conditions, type 1 diabetes people have really high blood sugar, and in turn, it can cause multiple damages to multiple organs. The next autoimmune disease involves the nervous system, called multiple sclerosis. Usually in our body, we have many nerves, and they are coated or protected by a special layer called myelin sheath. This protection to make sure that the signal transmission to any part of our body intact. In this autoimmune disease, multiple sclerosis, the damage to a myelin sheath slows the transmission speed or messages between our brain and other nerves. As a result, people have this condition, they may feel numbness, tingling, and balance issue. The specialist treat condition is the neurologist and or other specialists. Now you see that whenever the immune system attacks different organs, they have different names. We are moving from the nervous system with multiple sclerosis to a GI system. GI means the mouth, the esophagus, the stomach, the small intestine, and then colon. Now, when antibody attack different part of the GI tract, it has different name. For example, Crohn disease can inflame any part of the GI tract from the mouth to the anus, while ulcerative colitis affect only the lining of the large intestine or the colon. Speaking about GI tract, there is one disease that particularly important called celiac disease. In this disease, people cannot eat certain food contain gluten. This is a protein found in wheat, rye, and other grain products. So when gluten in the small intestine, the immune system attack this part of the GI tract and cause inflammations. So celiac is a disease that mostly can be controlled by diet, because you can see that gluten trigger the inflammations. How about thyroid? So if the immune system attacks thyroid, we have a different names. As you can guess, this is called Hashimoto disease. This is an autoimmune disease that affects the thyroid glands. Thyroid is the organ that produces vital hormone in our bodies, particularly dealing with energies. If we have too much thyroid, we feel too much energies. If we don't have enough thyroid, we feel sluggish, we feel really low energy, we gain weight. Now, in Hashimoto's, the antibody attack the thyroid cause the thyroid become inflamed. And as a result, the thyroid is malfunctions. It cannot produce enough thyroid. And some people, they may gain weight, they may feel low energies, they feel fatigue. And treatment simply suppress the immune system so there's less attack. Talk about symptoms, we talk about common diseases. Now, the question is, when should you see a doctor and who should you see? Well, in general, if you have those symptoms, you should see a family doctor first who can triage or evaluate your symptoms to see whether those symptoms sometimes could be just a common cold or something else. Then the family doctor or general doctor will refer you to see a specialist in autoimmune disease. In general, rheumatologists, they treat joint pain, they treat vasculitis, they treat lupus. Neurologists, they treat multiple sclerosis. Gastroenterologists, is it the GI specialist, they treat inflammatory bowel disease or celiac disease. Now, the dermatologists, they also treat psoriasis and psoriatic arthritis, also treated by rheumatologists. Endocrinologists treat thyroid problems like Hashimoto's. So it depends on the particular organs were affected by the immune system. You may see different specialists. What tests can diagnose autoimmune disease? Well, the short answer is there is no single test can diagnose autoimmune disease. Often, the autoimmune disease is diagnosed based on clinical symptoms, lab tests, and or imagings. The most common test and also the most misunderstanding test is called ANA or anti-nuclear antibody test. The test basically just to see how active your immune system by measuring the level of antibody attack all the organs. Now, remember, up to 5 or 10% of general population have positive ANA without any symptom or diseases. So it's okay for someone to have positive ANA. The best way to talk about this test is talk to your autoimmune disease specialist who will put into your clinical context with your symptoms with and all other things to make a final diagnosis. Let's talk about treatments for autoimmune disease. So far, we know that autoimmune diseases are caused by the immune system mistakenly attack our bodies, attack specific organs, and cause specific diseases. So the treatment is somehow, if we can control those attacks, obviously autoimmune disease cannot cure. And this is something that I often tell my patient, we go on to live with autoimmune disease. However, what we can do is we can control the immune system to make them less active, to make them less targeting our organs. And how do we do this? We have many, many drugs, and in each type of drugs, we have different ways to control our system. Now, the most common one that you may hear is called non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, or NSAIDs. Ibuprofen, Aleve, Motrin usually are the most first line of treatment for autoimmune disease. The second most common one is called steroids. Obviously, steroids will suppress or will hold the immune system, but long-term steroids have serious side effects. So talk to your doctor about how to or how much should you be on steroids. Other medication you may hear called DMARD or disease-modified anti-rheumatic drugs. This is a group of medication that particularly attacks or modifies the immune system. And some of them are plaquenil or hydroxychloroquine. This is the famous drugs in COVID-19. Now, other medications are called cyclosporin, methotrexate. Those are modifying the immune system. And lastly, we have something called biologics. Those are particularly small molecule drugs that attack the inflammation pathway. Recall the immune system sent out by a lot of antibody and cell to attack an organs. In order for the immune system to do so, it will send the message via multiple cascade. Biologic medication attack each pathway and block the message. Therefore, no antibody at the very end are produced, and therefore the autoimmune disease is controlled. So the bottom line is we have a lot of autoimmune diseases out there, about 80 of them, and the 10 more common diseases I spoke to you today. In next couple of videos, I will talk particularly about each one, and hopefully you will understand more about its conditions, and you may educate your patients or your friends about this. Thank you for supporting Dr. Wynn Tran channels on YouTube, and see you next time.